Morning, children. Today we are on to the next lecture on the IUPAC nomenclature of the organic compounds. And so far in my previous videos, I have discussed about individual functional groups or alkane, alkene, and exactly how to name the organic compound. Right? So now we will be discussing about some rules and apply them to different examples. Like the first rule says, that's a longest chain rule. Like what you are exactly supposed to do in case you are given some organic compound. I have written the carbon skeleton. Okay, you can complete the valencies. Each carbon is tetravalent. So one bond is there means there will be three hydrogens, two are there. So two and so on. Hydrogens you can complete on your own. So now basically if any organic compound is given to you to name, you will try to identify which is the longest chain in it. Now, how do you select the longest chain? It's not necessary. The chain has to go in a straight manner that you have to strike a straight chain. Your chain can go in any direction, but it should be the longest one in that particular compound. For example, if I see this straight chain, I'm having six carbon atoms in this, you know, six carbon atoms. Now, if I take this chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 I am having. So I am having in this 7 carbon atom. So I will be selecting this chain. This will be the selected chain. Okay, so I have first 2-3 examples. I will be just telling you how to select the chain. Because once the chain is selected, we will number it and then we will go ahead. Right. So we will come back to this naming. After I teach you the next rule, that is lowest sum rule. This one. Suppose I take the chain. If you are taking this chain, you are having three carbon atoms. So don't think you have to take always a straight chain. You go ahead and see your chain can go in any direction. It can go in zigzag manner. But it should be a continuous one. It should not have any branches further. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You cannot have a chain like this, this and then you are having like this. No, it has to be continuous. So you can select this as the chain. Right. You could have gone this way also. That is not a problem. That will not make it wrong. It will be the same. As long as the name is not getting affected and the length of the chain is fine, then okay. You could have taken 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 carbon atom. Then also the name will remain the same. Right. So selecting the chain is the first thing. Any organic compound you see, which is given to you to name it, you will first select the longest continuous chain. Next, suppose you have, you know, two equally long chains. Like for example here, this one. First, let me see the longest chain. Then we can decide whether they are equally long chains or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbon atoms in a chain. Let me see another one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have this one also. 5. So one option is this. 5 carbon atom. Another option is this. 5 carbon atom. Next one, let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But actually this one, the straight one and this 5 is the same. Right. So there are two options. If I take this one, one chain, or I may take the straight one. If I take the straight one, I am getting two branches, one branch here, one branch here, right? If I select this as the chain, or if I select this one, will be the same thing again. So if I select this one, five carbon atoms are there. So this one has five carbon atom, but it is having only one branch. Then which one should I go? I can select this as the chain, which is having more number of branches. So what is the rule saying? The rule says if two equally long chains are possible, you select the chain which is having more number of branches. So this is this rule containing large number of chains, right? Don't worry about this one. This also will be the same, right? If you take this one, then also it is the same. Okay, so that is not a problem. You can take that one also. But if two equally long chains are possible, you are going to select that chain which is having more number of branches. Now, let's take another example where branches are considered. If I take this chain, five carbon atoms are there. Let me see some other option. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I may take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm seeing all possible options, and then I will see which is having the longest, more number of branches. So obviously it cannot be, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you are having. This one I am taking, this is having 4. I think this is not having two equally long chains. You have only one option. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you have. Then you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If I go this way, then also it is same. So it is not having actually equally two long chains. So equally long chains were here. So here there, although there are two more than one equally long, but and all were having, you know, same number of branches. So there is no option here. You have to select this as the chain. Now further, how to name it, I will discuss just now. Okay. Now let's take some more examples, then I will start naming them. Now this one, let me select the chain first. Very clear, there is only one chain possible. You may have this one also, but the name is not getting affected. So as long as the name is not getting affected, there is no issue at all. What about this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm having, you know, two side chains. One chain here, another chain here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 I'm having. This is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 carbon atoms are there. So lengthwise is not correct because that is having 5 carbon atoms only. If I select this one, I'm having only one branch. So I will prefer, you know, going with this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, you can have, 1 second, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, in fact, this one is having 7, let me take this is also the longest continuous chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbon atoms are there. Let me first select the chain, then we will number. Next, this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is only one possible option. How to number it, we will do it just now. This 6 carbon atoms are there, straight chain if you see, and there is no other option, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 you have, but this, you know, will have less number of branches. So obviously you will have the straight chain as the longest chain, right? Once you have selected the chain, next what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to number the chain. Now let's start with the first one again, how to number the chain. We will number the chain from the side such that the side chain is getting a lesser position. So if I number from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is getting 5th position. If I start from here, then 1, 2, 3. So this is correct. This is, get, you know, from this side, if I start numbering, the side chain is getting the lesser position. So, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Right. So we will name it now. On the third carbon atom, there is one methyl group. Only carbon means, of course, if I complete its valency, it is CH3, right? So let us name it now. How do we name? That rule I have discussed already in my first video. That is prefix to be named first. What is the prefix? Anything which is not included in the main chain is the prefix. This is prefix, methyl. What position methyl is there? Third position. So its name becomes 3-methyl, that is the prefix. After the prefix, we are supposed to write the word root. Now, what is the word root for this one? The word root is hept, because 7 carbon atoms are there and all single bonds ane. 3-methyl heptane. Clear? Now let's take the second example. This is the lowest number rule or lowest locant rule. If I number from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 position, there was side chain. So, I will start numbering from here. Let the side chain be having lower position. So, if I am numbering from here, my side chain is having lesser position. What position it is there? Second position. So, I will write down the name as 2. There is methyl present over here. Then I will write down pent, because this is the prefix, this is the word root, and primary suffix, that is single bond. There is no secondary suffix as of now. If there is some functional group present, then that will be the secondary suffix, right? Now, let's name this. In this particular example, if I number from left, I'm getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What positions I'm having the side chains? 2 and 3. If I number from right, 1, 2, 3, 4, then I'm getting the side chains at 3 and 4 position. So from left hand side, if I'm numbering, I'm getting the side chains at 2 and 3 position. If I'm numbering from right hand side, I'm getting the side chains at 3 and 4 position. That means 3 and 4, like 1, 2, 3rd position and 4th position. So from where you're getting lesser sum, from that side you have to prefer numbering it. Now, which radicals are there? At 2 position you have methyl, at 3 position you have 2 carbon ethyl. So these two radicals are different. If the two radicals are different, they have to be numbered separately, writing their positions. So when we are naming it, we have to put all the prefixes in the alphabetical order. So you will write down 3 position there was ethyl, comma, 2 position there was methyl, right? Then the word root is pent, single bond zane. This is complete prefix, this is the word root, and this is the primary suffix. Clear? Now, chain we have already selected. I told you how to select the chain. Numbering. From right side, from left hand side, let me number it, and from right hand side. Because initially when I am teaching you, let me write the position so that it is clear to you. From left hand side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What positions I am having side chains? 2 position. There is one side chain at 2 position. 3 position, there are 2 side chains. So I will write down 3 twice. 3 plus 3. Okay. Let us see what is the, you know, sum. Sum comes out to be 8. Now, if I number from right hand side, then what positions I am having side chains? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means 3 position I am having 2 side chains plus 1 at 4. That means I am having 3 plus 3 plus 4. I am having the sum as 10. Which sum is more? We will not prefer numbering from there. We will prefer numbering from the side where the sum is less. So from left hand side it has to be numbered. Now 2 position there is methyl. 3 position also there is methyl plus there is ethyl also. So these two methyls you can combine together. So you can name first ethyl, that is 3 ethyl, and because at 2 and 3 positions there was methyl, we will write like this 2, 3 dimethyl. But positions you have to write down separately, 2 and 3, there is 2 position and 3 position methyl, so 2, 3 dimethyl, then the word root as pent, single bonds in pentane. Got it till here? Clear? Let's continue naming further. Numbering, of course, from right hand side. Now you know it. 3, 4, 5. 2 position there was methyl. So 2 methyl. And word root is pent. Primary suffix A. You cannot change the order. Keep prefix, I can write later on. No, prefix first, then word root, then primary suffix. Then next one. From where to number? From 1. 2, if I number like this, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What positions I am having side chains? I am having at left hand side 3, then I am having 1 at 4, that's say 3 plus 4. From this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Obviously from left hand side, I mean from here we have to number it. So, there is 3 position methyl, 4 position ethyl. You have to name the prefixes in the alphabetical order. So 4 ethyl, 3 methyl, and then the word root hept, single bonds ane. Hept ane. Got it? Now the next one. This is very clear. We have to number from right hand side because on 2 position itself there are 2. If I number from this side on 4, it will be 2 methyls. So you will be numbering from right hand side. What all things are there? All methyls only. Which all positions methyl? 2 position, there are 2 methyls. So 2, 2. even though on one carbon atom there are two methyls, you will write down the position separately. 2, 2 and then 4 also. 4. You have 3 total now. 2, 2, 4. Trimethyl. This is the prefix. Word root is pent. Single bonds. A. Clear? Now, from left hand side again. Now, I think that is clear. You can pause in between and write the name on your own and check it what I have written. This position there is ethyl. So, 3. 3 ethyl. Then remaining all are methyls. Which all positions? 2, 2, 5. Trimethyl. For methyl T, you don't have to see. You have to see this E. And then hex, single bonds, hex, in. 6 carbon atom, hex, single bonds, in. Hex A. Clear? Now, this I am just writing separately. Now, next, this is the next rule, naming complex substituents. In case you have some examples where the side chains are further complicated, then how to name it? We will take those examples. Let's take these examples now. This was clear. They were, straight chain only we have to select. And looking at the position, we know we have to number from left hand side, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 carbon atoms. Now, what is this radical we have to say? There are 5 carbon atoms, but 5 are not present in the length. They are present as branches also. You cannot name this as neopentyl also, because neopentyl is not considered to be the IUPAC name. Then what to do? You need to select the longest side chain. This anyhow is the prefix. We know this. So, in this side chain, you have to select the longest side chain. Which is the longest side chain? Such that the side chain further doesn't have branches. You cannot select like this. You have to select longest side chain. And you number this side chain from the point of attachment. This is attached from this carbon atom to the main chain. So you number the side chain from the point of attachment. And this is the propyl radical. On propyl at 2 position there are 2 methyls present. And further, this particular thing is present at 4 position to the main chain. So now what you do? First you see, what is this whole side chain attached at? Which carbon atom it is attached at? 4 carbon atoms. So you will write down 4 outside the bracket. Put it inside the bracket. Now, what is the main chain for us? Propyl. On propyl, main chain means main side chain. That is propyl. On propyl, there are 2 prefixes present. 2 position, there are 2 methyls present. So, we will write down as 2,2-dimethyl. 2,2-dimethyl are present on what? On propyl. So, we will write down 2,2-dimethyl propyl. Now, you must be wondering, there are 2 methyl propyls also coming. Because there is a complicated side chain. If there is a complicated side chain, you have to select the longest side chain. Number it from the point of attachment. And then outside the bracket, you write down on which position the side chain, the complicated thing is present on the main chain. And then the prefixes of the side chain. Then the main word root of the side chain as radical only. And then close the bracket. Word root for 9 is non single bond in. So it's a complex side chain. Okay. Now let's see one more such example. Let's see how many carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 carbon atoms. Yes. 10 carbon atoms in a straight chain. But that, if I select that, there are only 2 side chains. One side chain and one this complicated. If I select the one which I have marked, this is having more number of branches. So, we need to apply all the rules together to whatever name is given to you. So, this is the selected chain. This is also having 10 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. As per the least sum rule, we have to number from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Now, you see what all things are present, where they are present. At 3 position, there are 2 methyls, right? And at 5th, there is 1, 4 carbon atom. You cannot say ki 4, 5, 6 like this. If I am selecting then this and then, there will be a branch like this. You cannot have something like this. You have to select the longest side chain. This is again a complicated chain. Longest side chain. This is my longest side chain. You cannot select that as a longest side chain because this will have further two branches attached to the main chain. Number this longest side chain from the point of attachment, that is this. So what is the main side chain present? Butte. On butte at one position there is ethyl also present. So anyway, as the alphabetical order, I have to name this part first, then methyls. Where is this butte present? On fifth carbon atom. So I will write down 5 outside the bracket. On fifth carbon atom, butte is present. But on that butyl, one position there is ethyl also. So I will write on 1. Ethyl is present on what? Butyl. Main, where it is present? What is present? On that what? Which side chain is present? Where? So that position I have written. 1 ethyl butyl. Then I will number these other branches. What were the branches? I will name them as 3-dimethyl. At 3 position there were 2 methyls present. Dec for single bond, 10 carbon atoms and single bond in. Dec-ene. This is the complete name. Okay. See, at the end, you know, I mean, in the next video I will give you one assignment sort also. You can just try those questions on your own. Now let's see how to name unsaturated hydrocarbons, means if there is multiple bond, then if there is multiple bond, double or triple bond, then even though there is a longer chain possible, you need to select that chain which includes multiple bond. You have to ignore a longer chain. As and when the things are present in it, you need to change the rules. If I select this, I'm getting 6 carbon atom, but this chain, if I select, the double bond is ignored. I cannot ignore the double bond. I have to include the double bond in my chain. So this is my chain. Now, when I am giving numbering, double bond has to be given preference. And now you know the double bond is present between 1 and 2 carbon atom. But I will write down as 1. Lower position is written. Now, what is the prefix present? At 2 position, there is ethyl. So I will write down 2. Remaining things are same. The prefix will be there. Word root will be there. Pent. But now instead of ane, even though there are all remaining single bonds, but even if one double bond comes, the suffix will change. As it is present at what position? One position. I will write down as 1 ene. Many a times if one position, double or triple is there, we may ignore the position, but it's always better you write down the position. You are more correct that way. Clear? So now again, remember this part is clear. Even though a longer chain is possible, you need to include the carbon atoms containing multiple bond. If double and triple both are there, then this of course is a chain. We know that there is no other possibility. If both are present, double and triple. Now where should I number from? From left or right? From whichever side they are getting lesser positions. If I number from this side, I am getting the positions as 1, 2, 3, 4. That means I am getting the double or triple whatever 2 and 4 position. But if I number from right hand side, I am getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Means I am getting positions as 1 and 3. So I will prefer numbering from right hand side. This is correct. Now the prefix is missing. The word root will be pent. Then, now ene, ene, ene you can skip if ene or ene is present. But if double and triple both are there, both have to be given a name along with the positions. Of course, alphabetical order, these suffixes have to be written. What position they are there? 3 position, double bond. So we will write down as 3, ene, and 1 position there was ene. Right? So again that E I have deleted. So it is 3 ene, 1 ene. Take this example. If I number from left hand side, double is getting first position. If I am numbering from right hand side, triple is getting first. If from either side, if you are checking, there is a competition between double and triple, double is always given preference. That is always given a lesser position. Clear? Now, let's number, name them. Butte, 1, ene. And then you have, this will be dash, 1 ene and 3 ene. This E will be deleted. Clear? Now, if they are getting different positions, then whichever side whichever is getting lesser position. You see the sum of the positions. But if from either side they are getting similar position, this side double is first, this side triple is first, give preference to double bond. Here both are double. Either side position is not getting affected. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, there is one rule here. If a double bond or a triple bond is appearing more than once, a suffix will be added to the word root. So you will write down the buta. Now buta, because double bond is present twice. Buta, then you have 1, 3, diene. This ene is present twice at one position and three positions. So buta, 1, 3, diene. Clear? Same way here, triple bond is present more than once. So what we will do is, we will write down the, this is methyl, three position methyl, three methyl. Then you have the word root as penta, because it is present twice, one and four positions. So you'll write down penta, 1, 4, diene, you will write. Clear? Now, sometimes you will also find that, they do not write the carbon atom. They just write down the bond line notation. Yes, bond line notation means they just represent the bonds like this. They do not write in a straight manner because, for every bend there is a carbon atom. Right? So, for every bend there is a carbon means there will be one carbon here. There will be one carbon here. There will be one carbon here. There'll be one carbon here. So like this, if I write in this case, each first one I'm showing you, the other two you will try out on your own. Double bond, this you can expand it like this, this and a double bond. So instead of writing this way, you can also find many times this is asked, name this. It's a bond. What is this called? What is this way of writing down called? Bond line notation. Just they are represented in the form of the bonds. Okay. Yes, so even this one is a bond line notation. You can try out what is the name. Expand it like this if you're not comfortable. And this is another one, right? So if the more carbon atoms are there, they are given a bend like this. Like here also, there is a bend. Means one carbon here, one carbon here. Same way, one carbon here, one carbon here, one carbon here. And a triple bond is shown like this, right? So this you can try out on your own and see what are the names. And if you're okay with, fine. Otherwise, you can ask your doubts in the comment section. Thanks for watching.